Yeah. This is another story about dogs.
On November 23rd, 1993, the world had a musical earthquake, I like to say, with the first album from Snoop, Doggy Dogg at the time, called Doggystyle. We had heard him on 187 on the Cop, which was the Deep Cover soundtrack, and after that with the Chronic record. When he had his own album come out, his solo album come out, it was just music, not just hip hop, but music itself hadn't heard anything like that ever. To me, it was a little more melodic, I should say, you know, with the intro. And then just think about it, the intro. He had Rage open up the whole record. Not even Rage opened up the whole record, was just bussing. And that was different for us in general. So, you know, that record still to this day could be played with the best of them. It's well mixed, it's well mastered, you know, the subject matters are still around. Gin and juice, it ain't no fun. These are things that people still do, you know. It's, and to me, that's what makes a timeless record. So the Doggystyle record is definitely in the world of a timeless classic, you know, just as much as the Miles Davis and the John Coltrane record is also, just as much. This record really shaped the sound for gangster rap, I should say, also, because these are things that we still follow. We still follow the Dr. Dre mode. If you want to be successful in Los Angeles, musically, you're gonna follow that Dr. Dre mode. You know, that's what we did for Good Kid, M.A.A.d City, for YG's album, and whoever's album I work on, these are some of the records that we have to go to, the Chronic and Doggystyle. What that album did for me is that was the first album I felt a real emotion. It made me sad when I heard Murder Was the Case, how he was given the opportunity, good or bad, to make a deal with the devil to save his life. So it made you think about reality, things like that. It also made you think about when you meet this girl that everybody else is fucked on or whatnot, do you want to be with her? Because it ain't no fun if the homies can't have none. I mean, the fact Nate Dogg said, and she even licked my balls and sang that, it tickled me. And I think it tickled the world too. And that's what Doggystyle did. It gave you every bit of emotion that you could possibly have through the course of a musical outline. And it was just pure genius to me. And I'm also so fortunate that my first entry to the game at 16, 17 years old was with Snoop Dogg, and I'm still with Snoop to this day. You know, so kudos to Doggystyle. Without that record, music would be totally different. I get smoked and loony. Bitch, you can't do me. Do we look like BBD? You hoochie groupie. I have no love for hoes. That's something that I...